A listener to the videos asks, do comic creators just get a little bit more crazy as they get older? And pointing to, I mean, you know, the shining example here is Alan Moore and his weird snake god, which people often think that I'm joking or that's some kind of flippant comment. No, that's actually, there's a snake god involved. So let's talk about it. Hey there, this is Perch. I want to clear up any misconceptions from that intro. We're not going to be talking strictly about Alan Moore's Snake God, but we are going to be talking about just comic creators in general. And as they get older, some of the inhibitions kind of wear off. Now, you might argue, I think correctly, that this is true of people in general, that as they get older, especially when they get to retirement and they no longer have to, put on any kind of illusion of going into an office and behaving themselves, that they just get weird. That suddenly I don't have to wear pants today, or I've decided to be super racist, or whatever it happens to be. These things kind of enter into the mind and the spirit of people as they get older and as they, don't have as much interaction with people, or as the interaction just gets less structured, rather than going into a job and being in meetings and selling clients and having to, partner up with people to get things done, your day consists of, going to Walmart and going golfing and, hanging around and thinking about the weather. That sounds terrible. And I'm, we're all getting older. So I don't want anybody to think that I'm bagging on old people because we're all going to be one. I mean, hopefully, or if there's the alternative, but this is just kind of normal that it happens. With comics, I think there's a valid argument to be made that as you get older, many things happen in comics. I mean, first of all, as a profession in general, as I've talked about in other videos, it's not the most stable, especially if you're a writer, artist, one of those people. You either have a good family, good friends, good support structure, and you'll notice that people like that tend to be kind of just buttoned up, normal people, or you have people who, went into the creative field because, for the reason that it was more isolating and they could kind of, set their own hours, do what they want. And they don't, they have a very small community of people like them that think like them that don't necessarily encourage them to stretch and grow. And their day to day typically is in their own house, in a room, at a desk, in isolation, watching, having YouTube playing in the background while drawing or writing. And that there's, there's nothing wrong with all that. But if you have certain, and on top of that, the creative field in general, whether you're an actor or a musician or an artist or a writer, it just does tend to lend itself more to, creativity, imagination. And those things also tend to lend themselves a little bit more toward, maybe not the most buttoned up behavior in the world. I mean, when you're George R. R. Martin, why do you need to necessarily get along with others? Why you're inventing dragon worlds. You don't have to necessarily, you get the point. Anyway, if you look at comics in general and you see a bunch of the older creators, what you start to notice is that the older creators tend to get more, they're not doing as much work. Typically there's new faces on the scene and they're the ones who the companies are promoting. The editorial in all the publishers tends to, favor people within their circle. And there's also this really obnoxious belief that I think has no basis in fact that says, that art style or that writing style gets tired out. I heard that and it was confusing. So I remember arguing with somebody over this and I said, you're telling me if Todd McFarlane said, I want to do 3 years on Spider-Man, drawing Spider-Man, not even writing it, just drawing it. You're telling me you'd go, that style is tired. That's an old style. I think I'd prefer to, we'll get this guy down here in Ecuador. He can do it. I remember making the same argument about George Perez, Chris Claremont writing comics and X-Men. There's this attitude I've gotten from time to time saying, well, those styles are played out. They're old. If you want something new, I don't think so. I think people want, but you put Tom McFarlane on Spider-Man, C.B. Smolsky, that's how you get your million copies. I mean, you know, I'm just saying. But there is this, you know, as the older creators kind of exit necessarily the day-to-day parts of comics, they do give interviews and they go to comic cons and they go on social media increasingly. And they tend to be the most nuts. I mean, I've had really good interactions with people like Kevin Aguirre, for example. Really, I think, had very solid interactions with him at a show. But also, probably one of the more, I would say, the more disappointing interactions I've had tend to be with older creators, because they just tend to be a little bit, they're irritable about what's going on. And I think I've gone off track. I've too many ideas are kind of going into my head all at once. And also, I mean, this topic, why I'm getting a little befuddled here is that it's a shame because, I mean, I grew up with a lot of these guys and these women that are legendary. These men and women who wrote stories that are stuck in my head forever. I mean, Louise Simonson, Walt Simonson's run on X Factor is in my mind always. I mean, John Buscema, his work on Avengers and Conan and other things. I mean, there's some amazing. The things that Marv Wolfman and George Perez did, the things that, I mean, hell, it's weird to think about it this way, but the Image guys are considered older, you know, definitely older creators now. They're you know, that was the 90s when you had, you know, Todd McFarlane and Mark Silvestri and Jim Valentino and Eric Larson. And you had a lot of huge attention to them now, but that was 30 years ago. It's strange to think about. So I do think that, again, this came as a question from somebody. Do the older creators kind of start to, you know, lose it a little bit? And the answer is, yeah, I think they do. I think that a lot of it is justifiable because, like I mentioned, I think there's been a kind of this weird subtle push of the industry to promote newer people over them for no apparent reason. And I also think, you know, you've been in this creative community so long, you've been working this way for so long. I think I've given a lot of reasons, but I haven't ever concluded a point here in this video. It's a shame because I think, you know, in many cases, you look at John Byrne kind of losing his mind over on his board a few years ago. And now he has the reputation in the industry of being this kind of very arrogant, very dismissal, you know, jerk. You have Dan Jurgens, who's still, you know, a great artist and does a lot of things. He's got quite a reputation going on Twitter. You have people like Gail Simone who are, you know, have a big reputation on Twitter. I mean, these people, I mean, there's kind of a common thread you start to see where, you know, over several years, the comments and the ideas and the other things kind of stack up. And I think there also gets to be kind of a behavior of, you know, maybe I need to be more and more outspoken or outlandish to get myself kind of back in the spotlight or get attention put back on me. That I think that goes on as well. And again, it's a somewhat untethered profession in general because people are just left to their own devices. And yes, you know, Alan Moore has a snake god that he apparently, I don't know, worships or communes with. I don't know. There's a snake god in the mix. Go check it out on Wikipedia or just type in Alan Moore snake god into Google. You'll learn all that you ever wanted to and more. I don't know. Maybe, who knows? Another, you know, 20 years, maybe I'll have a snake god. I mean, it could happen. I mean, that I don't know if it was a snake, though. It's a snake. I can't, it has no legs. I can't respect that. I can't put on shoes. That's my problem. I mean, you know, you can't put on shoes. Why? I don't think so. Anyway, there you go. What are your comments? Do you have creators that you really liked, you really respected, and then, you know, as they get later on in their career, you know, like Peter David, so on. I think he does great work, but his panels at Comic Cons have gotten progressively more, you know, a little bit more nutty than they were back in the late 80s, 90s. It's just weird how that works. Are there any people that you really, really liked, and then it kind of is like a, oh, that's a shame kind of feel? Like you caught them on a bad day. You hope that it's not a normal thing. Like I said, I've met Kevin Maguire a lot, many times. Always liked the guy, like his art. His run on Justice League is another one where it's like, I think that's legendary. Some of the stuff that he did. And I had one con where he was in a salty kind of bad mood, and it had that feeling of like, jerks. And I don't know. It always, I don't want to have those experiences. I want to have that good memory of that creator always in my mind. So what about you? Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think. Like and subscribe. Please, I wasn't just doing this video to crap on old people. That wasn't the intention either. Just it's just an interesting phenomenon that I'm noticing. Anyway, like, subscribe, follow me on Twitter, Comic Perch. Thanks for listening.